Imagine a place so violent, so dark, even light cannot escape its destruction. We are talking about a black hole. It's space in our universe that bends the mind of even the most respected and smartest scientists on the planet. Surrounded by absolute darkness. Black holes are a part of space in which gravity is so strong that light is not able to escape from it. Therefore, it's not possible to see a black hole. Respected scientists study the behavior of space surrounding a black hole, like a beautiful star losing its mass because a black hole is consuming parts of it, ripping the star apart piece by piece. Black holes are not bound by our laws of physics. They have staggering ways of dealing with the matter around them. It's a part of space so powerful, time ticks more slowly when you get near. But where do these dark monsters come from? It's important to understand that everything in our universe needs energy to stay alive. When a star dies, because it runs out of fuel to keep its core stable, it will collapse on itself. There will be a supernova explosion. This explosion happens at a speed up to 40,000 kilometers a second. That is 72,000 times faster than shooting a bullet from a gun. The speed is so astonishing that in less than 1 second, it can travel the entire Earth once. After this intense explosion happens, the black hole is formed. But there is one simple rule. To become this giant darkness, the mass that stays behind must be at least 3 times the mass of our own sun. Meaning that when this massive star was alive, it had to be 50 to 100 times bigger than our own sun. That is so large that about 65 million planet Earths can fit inside of it. These black holes are called stellar mass black holes. They are relatively small but deadly. They collapse to such a dense state that you could fit the sun in a small city on Earth. They slowly grow in size and consume the dust and gas from the galaxy around them. According to the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics, the Milky Way contains a few hundred million stellar black holes. But this is just a tiny fraction of what comes next. Say hello to its big brother. Supermassive black holes. These black holes are millions to billions times more massive than our own sun. Scientists are not entirely sure how they are formed. There are several options they have come up with. Number one, the collapse of a stellar cluster, a group of stars all collapsing together. When they collapse, they merge into one supermassive black hole. Number two, the colliding of mega dust clouds, or in simple terms, dust in space. Different clouds finding each other and colliding to become one. And number three, it's a collection of thousands of stellar black holes, all merged together and becoming a supermassive black hole. All three possibilities are truly fascinating. And explosive theories of massive events in outer space. But let's not forget the intermediate black holes. We don't know too much about them, other than that they start as a relatively small black hole and slowly fall together in the center of a galaxy and become supermassive black holes. We talked about gravity. Let's dive into its important role inside a black hole. Since the gravitational pull from a black hole is so large, there is a point in which when you cross it, there is no turning back. This is called the event horizon. But why is there no turning back? Because you would need to be faster than the speed of light to escape the gravitational pull at the heart of the black hole. Now, let's imagine falling into a black hole and passing the so-called event horizon. You are now entering a place in which light can no longer escape. You slowly get ripped apart and time is no longer relevant. Your body gets broken into pieces, 2 becomes 4, 4 becomes 8, and 8 becomes 16, until you are nothing but a stream of energy that is being consumed by a black hole. But why are black holes formed from the supermassive explosion? Since the star is failing to get new fuel, gravity is still pulling on the mass of the star. It's crumbling and slowly becoming denser. To better understand, imagine a bowling ball with the mass of the sun, being pulled so hard by gravity from all sides that the bowling ball becomes smaller and smaller. The mass of the bowling ball is being crushed into such a dense state. The friction of the gravitational pull makes the bowling ball become hotter. The gravity manages to crush the bowling ball to an ant size. At some point, the force is so great that the bowling ball explodes. With a black hole, we call that the supernova explosion. Since it only explodes the outer side of the bowling ball, the inside has become an infinitely dense point. The laws of physics we use don't apply anymore. A black hole has formed. Now, when a black hole is formed, it has what we call an accretion disk. Another layer right before we enter the event horizon, the point of no return. When matter or gases get closer to the event horizon, the pull of the black hole accelerates them, and this creates an enormous amount of friction. The friction, as explained before, heats all the elements, and this creates electromagnetic energy, like X-rays or visible lights. We as humans shouldn't be too worried about being consumed by a black hole. We know now that the sun is simply a tiny star that is not capable of becoming a black hole. Now, before we end this dark journey, let's say we survive the trip inside a black hole. What lies behind it? Where does all the mass go? It's the million-dollar question. Maybe another universe. Find out in future episodes which theories are most likely to be true. Thank you for watching. We have given you a small look into this subject. We might have missed something. We might have gotten something wrong. Let us know what your thoughts are. We hope you stay around for another episode. Only if you like this video, please subscribe to see more episodes.